Hi everyone, welcome to Do Maths with me. On this channel, we believe that practice makes perfect. That's why we are not just here to teach you math, we are here to do the exercises with you. Together, we'll solve the challenging problems step by step, so you can learn from the exercises and I will explain the concepts along the way. If you are ready to unlock your full math potential, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and like this video to give me support. Let's get started. Today we'll be learning from 5 Math, Chapter 3, Insurance. I have gathered some key points about this chapter, which we will then apply them in the exercises later. So first, we have the equation for premium. So in order to calculate premium, we'll use the face value of the policy. So let's say I have a life insurance, which will cover for 100,000. So the 100,000 will be my face value of the policy. Divide by RMX. So the X here will be normally is 1,000. So let's say just now I mentioned we have 100,000. It will then be divided by 1,000 multiplied with how much is the premium rate per 1,000 ringgit. So let's say it's a 2 ringgit per 1,000. So in order to calculate the premium, it will then be 100 multiplied by 2 and I get 200. And bear in mind, this 200 is for annual premium. So let's say my annual premium is 200. So if the question asks me about my monthly premium, it will then be 200 divided by 12. So remember, this equation here is for an annual premium. For motor insurance, we have 3 different types. First is the comprehensive policy, and we have third party fire and theft policy, and the last one will be the third party only. So in order to calculate the premium of the third party fire and theft policy, it is 75% of the comprehensive. If it's a third party policy, you just need to look at the table and that is how much you have to pay. Next we have deductible, which is certain amount that the policy holder have to bear before he can get the compensation. So for this equation here are for the core insurance. So an example for core insurance will be 80-20, which means 80% will be paid by the insurance company and 20% is paid by the policy holder. So in number 4 here, we have amount of required insurance, which is the amount of insurance that you have to buy based on your core insurance percentage. So in order to calculate how much you have to buy, it will be 80 multiply with how much is the value of your property. So I will show you how to use this equation. So I will show you how to use this equation in the exercises later. So next we have 2 scenarios. First is the amount of insurance that you have purchased equal to the amount of required insurance. So you have buy what you need to buy. So in order to calculate the compensation under this scenario, it will just be how much you lost minus deductible, and that is how much you get back from the insurance company. So in the second scenario is the amount of insurance purchased less than the required insurance, which means you buy less than what you have to buy. So in this scenario, your compensation payment will be slightly complicated. It will be how much you have purchased divided by how much you have to purchase. So let's say I have to purchase 100,000, but I only purchased 80,000. So this 80 will be the amount of insurance purchased. I purchased 80,000. And this 100,000 will be how much I need to buy. So in this scenario, because I didn't buy the 100,000 fully, I only buy 80,000. So I need to calculate the amount that I have purchased is how many percent of what I need to purchase. So it will be 80,000 divided by 100,000. So it will be 80%. So I only buy 80% of what I should buy. So it makes sense that how much you'll get back of your losses will be only 80% of your losses. So this formula here is just to let you know the insurance that you have purchased is how many percent of your required insurance. And you get the percentage and you multiply with the losses minus deductible, and that is the final compensation you get. Alright, so now let's look at the exercises. First, we have Remy, who has undergone nose surgery with a medical cost of 6,800 ringgit. And this is the details of his policy. So he has deductible of 800 and is a co-insurance. So the 60% here will be by the insurance company. And 40% will be paid by Remy, who is the policy holder. And the question is asking for how much money does Remy has to pay to the hospital. So how much money does Remy has to bear? So first we need to calculate how much he can claim. And that will be after your deductible. So 6,800 minus deductible, it will be 6,000. So this 6,000 will be bear by the insurance company and also Remy. And insurance company has 60% and Remy will be the remaining 40%. So now we have to calculate how much Remy have to pay, which will be the 40% of the 6,000. It will then be 6,000 multiplied with 40% plus the deductible. So don't forget the deductible, because the deductible is also something that the policyholder has to bear. And the answer will be 3,200, which is boy. Next, we have Anzek Anan purchased the fire insurance for his house. And the insured value of the house is 2.4 million. So 1 million equal to 60. So 2.4 million will be 2400000. And with a co-insurance of 75% and a deductible of 20,000. And 8 months later, his house caught on fire, which caused a loss of 500,000. So first, state the amount of deductible, and it will just be 20,000 here. So this answer will be 20,000. Next, calculate the amount of required insurance. So how much Anjek Anand have to pay? So remember the fourth point in the previous slide? Amount of required insurance will be the percentage multiplied with your insured number. So it will be 75% multiplied with 2.4 million. It will then be 1.8 million. So this 1.8 million is how much Anjek Anand have to buy. But did he really purchase this 1.8 million? We don't know. So let's look at the question. Calculate the amount of insurance purchased by Anjek Anam. So now we need to calculate how much that Anjek Anam really buy. So he has a loss of 500,000 and this is how much he get back. So now we need to use the six equations in the previous slide to calculate how much that Anjek Anam really purchased. So in order to calculate compensation, it will be how much you have purchased divided by how much you should purchase, multiply with the loss and minus your deductible. So now we want to calculate how much he has purchased. So in order to calculate how much he has purchased, we need to move this minus deductible to left hand side, become plus deductible. Then we move the should and the losses to the left hand side as well. So we have purchase equal to your compensation plus your deductible divide by your loss is a multiplier here. When you move to left hand side, it will become division. So divide by your loss, multiply with your should, and it will be 430,000 of your compensation plus 20,000 divide by your loss is 500,000. Multiply with the should, it will be 1.8 million here. And you will get 1.62 million. And that is the answer. Next, we have Anzir Fazli have a fire insurance for his house. And the insurable value is 380,000. Co-insurance is 80% of this 380,000. And we have the deductible is 6,000. So calculate amount of insurance that should be taken by an exact fuzzy. So for the insurance that you should buy, it will be your percentage multiplied with the value. So A, it will be 80% multiplied with 380,000. And you get 304,000. So next, unsafe fire health suffer fire and the loss is 75,000. Calculate the compensation. If what he has purchased is 228,000 only, instead of this 304,000 that he should buy. So B, we have the compensation formula. It will be how much you purchase divide by how much you should, multiply your loss minus your deductible. Then it will be 228,000 divided by 304,000. Multiply the losses is 75,000 minus deductible 6,000. So the answer will be 50,250. So this is the compensation that he will get. Next, we have Anzek Malay has a fire insurance for his house, which worth 600,000. And he bought the co-insurance, which is 90% of the insurable value and a 5,000 deductible. Then Anzek Malay house caught on fire. If what he has purchased is 400,000 and he received a compensation of 75,000, calculate the loss from the fire. So now we can calculate how much he should buy, which is 600,000 multiplied with 90%. And you also know how much he has already bought, which is 400,000. And this is the compensation that he received. And from here, you need to calculate the loss. So let's use back the number 6 equation from the previous slide. So we know compensation equal to your purchase divided by how much you should buy, multiply with your loss minus deductible. So now we want to calculate what is the loss. So first, we move the deductible to left-hand side and we move this purchase overshoot to left-hand side as well. So we have compensation plus deductible equal to purchase divided by should multiplied with loss. Then we move this divide to left-hand side, it will become multiplication. And we move the purchase to left-hand side, it will become division. So it will be the compensation plus deductible multiply with should divide by purchase. It will then be your loss. So first we need to calculate how much is the should buy. 90% multiplied with the 600,000. And it will be 540,000. So now we can calculate the loss. It will be your compensation is 75,000 and your deductible 5,000. Multiply with your should buy divided by what you have purchased is 400,000. And you will get 108,000. So that is the answer. Next, we have Hidayah bought a new house and she wanted to buy the fire insurance for her house. The insurable value is 200,000 and it's a co-insurance plan, so it's 80% and the deductible is 6,000. So calculate the amount of insurance required. So this is how much Hidayah should buy. So we know should buy will be equal to your percentage multiplied with the insurable value. So A, it will be 80 divided by 100 multiply with 200,000 and you'll get 160,000. Next, Hidayah's house caught fire and she has a losses of 50,000. Calculate the compensation if she insured her house at amount required. So she bought what she have to buy. In this case, it will then be the fifth equation from the previous slide. So the compensation will just be the loss minus deductible. So the losses is 50,000, multiply the deductible which she should bear, and it's 6,000. So the final answer is 44,000. And that's it. And that's all for today. We have completed these math exercises together step by step. Now it's your turn to try. I have put a link to this question in the description box, so try it out if you can solve these exercises on your own. Remember, practice is the key to mastering math. Keep challenging yourself with more exercises and watch your skill grow. Don't forget to subscribe to Do Math With Me for more math exercises. Keep up the great work, keep learning, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.